Welcome back, Fox 8 News in the morning. Our good friend, Chef Eric Wells, is here to share a recipe from his first cookbook, something he's been working on for a while. It's called Intimate Dinners for Two, and it highlights his time catering for couples in their homes here in Northeast Ohio. Plus, he's going to show us a special recipe and the story behind the recipe. First of all, congratulations, man.
Thank you, Wayne. This has been a labor of love. I'm excited to officially release the book.
It's amazing. You've been with us for 14 years. You are actually working at Progressive when you started, and you just rolled the dice with this, huh?
Yeah, you know, I was doing both this, doing my private chef thing and working at Progressive until 2012, and just kind of stepped out on faith and, you know, just heard the call, you know, to leave Progressive and go out and do this full time. And it's just been amazing over the last 7 years doing this full time.
It's been good for you. All right, talk about the book. Now, basically, what's it about and what does it feature?
So there are about 60 or so recipes, all the recipes are actually for two. So it's not just for couples. It's great for, you know, father, daughter, mother, son, you know, so it doesn't need
speaking of mother, son.
My mother right there. That was my wedding day in 1997.
Yeah, yeah.
My mother is no longer with us, but that was a great memory. And, you know, all the recipes, as I mentioned, are for two.
Okay.
And then what we did here was we took about 29 stories of couples that I've done dinners for two for, and they just shared their stories, so how they met, and it's a love story. The book is a love story, is what it is, and it's some amazing stories of some amazing couples that I have in the book.
Now, the foreword is written by a friend of the show as well. Talk about the foreword.
So Stephanie Paganini is an amazing woman. I you know, we're like brother and sister. We kind of look alike a little bit. If you kind of look at us,
really look at you real good.
Yeah, look at us real good. We got to look alike. But Stephanie and the entire Paganini family has been so integral in my career and in my growth. I love them so much. Loretta's been wonderful, and I'm like their adopted son, you know. So Stephanie is like my sister.
So many
here.
People have come through that school, though,
done some amazing chefs that have come through that school.
Talk about the you're gonna do a recipe now, and is there a story behind this recipe that you're putting together today?
Well, the story here is I just, first of all, I love the salad. This is an amazing salad. We're doing an arugula salad.
Okay, but it's not tied to any of the people in the book.
Not necessarily.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
But it's an arugula salad with pears. Some Gorgonzola cheese and some toasted walnuts, and we're gonna make a honey vinaigrette with
Let's get to it.
So let's start with our vinaigrette here. So we're gonna start with a little shallots. Shallots are like onions, okay? And we're gonna add some garlic in here, a little garlic. And then what we're gonna do is go ahead and add our red wine vinegar. So we got about a half a cup of red wine vinegar.
Okay.
And then this is the big thing. We're gonna go ahead and add our honey in here.
Oh,
so this is just some nice honey to make it nice and sweet here. Really good. So then we're gonna make our dressing. So what I'm gonna have you do here, Wayne, is just kind of whisk as I add our olive oil. So whenever you make a vinaigrette, you have to slowly add the oil in as someone you know, you can do it at the same time.
I like it, man. I'm glad I'm helpful, man. I'm usually just watching.
Yeah, you usually are just watching.
Thank you for putting me to work. I appreciate
that.
Let me ask you this. It just got, as you put this together, how many couples have you cooked for, do you think? You probably don't even know offhand, or do you?
Not exactly, but it's been over 1,000. Over 1,000
in 7 years?
In 15 years.
In 15 years?
Yeah, going on 15 years.
Incredible.
So, it's just amazing couples. I'm just blessed. And
how did you decide who you're going to do? This couple right here, talk about these.
So this couple right here, this is Don and Kim. It's one of my favorite couples. Kim was the first person to contact me when I was first on Fox 8 back in 2005.
Oh, she saw you on Fox 8.
The first time.
Shout out Fox 8.
Yeah, you and I were together, and she saw me.
That's right. I was your first.
You were my first.
I remember that. Yeah.
So, and she contacted me.
Because, I knew your dad and all that. It's a whole other story.
Yeah,
go ahead. Yeah.
So she contacted me and said she wanted me to cook for her and her family and friends. And I've cooked for her several times. Yeah. Kim's kind of battling cancer right now. I'm praying for you, Kim.
Yes.
I hope all is well.
Absolutely.
But Kim, Don, and the entire family, they're wonderful people.
Yeah.
And I love them so much.
So all the people in the book you have a personal relationship with, I would say.
Exactly.
You've developed a personal relationship.
Exactly, exactly.
That's good stuff.
So we added a little salt, added a little pepper here.
Yeah, hey ladies.
Hi, how are you?
We're going to go ahead and get our salad. So the interesting thing with the salad, we're going to add the vinaigrette to the bottom
that's,
of the bowl.
See, that's interesting. Mm.
See, a lot of people just kind of pour it over.
Absolutely. That's what most people do.
Why do you put it on the bottom?
Because we want this to properly coat the lettuce. If you just pour it over the top, the top of the lettuce is nicely coated, but the bottom of the lettuce is dry.
So how do you bring it up to the top?
So what you're going
to
do this is just kind of toss it here.
Oh, okay. You toss it. I got you.
Try to keep some of it in a bowl here.
That's okay.
So, and then we're going to take our plate, and it's really simple and easy. Man. Gonna move this out the way. Yeah, that honey vinaigrette is amazing. So we're just gonna kind of.
So first of all, now if people want to, first of all, pick up your cookbook, how can they do that?
So in a day or so, we'll have kind of a link onto my website to pick up the book. Okay. But I'm also having a book release signing.
Where's that gonna be?
That's gonna be at Cornucopia Place, which is 7201 Kinsman, and that will be on Sunday.
This coming Sunday.
From 3 to 6 p.m.
Nice.
So come on, I'll have some food.
Hey.
No way.
Hey, that
Chef Eric Wells always has food.
Yeah, you do.
So we're going to do our pear slices over the top and then a little goat cheese.
Oh, yummy. Oh,
blue cheese, I'm sorry, over the top.
That's okay.
Oh,
cheese.
Cheese.
Look at that.
Cheese.
Margaret needs a picture before we devour
Can I just start right here?
Okay, yeah.
We'll move the bowls in the front.
Okay, let's move these.
Okay. You want to put this here and get a shot of it?
Okay.
Okay, there you go. Let's get a nice shot of this, John.
We need a good picture.
How nice is that?
And then we can. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's
awesome. And, you know, I hope you guys enjoy. We're going to give you guys some tongs here.
So we can just dig
in. Chef, congratulations on the book.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you.
It's a labor of love. I'm excited. And, you know, thanks, Fox 8. You know, you guys have been amazing for my career.
We love when you come out. We're like, yeah, Chef Eric Rose is coming out today.
We love you.
Thank you, guys.
All right.
Thank you.
We'll be right back, Stiggins.
Let's eat.
Fox 8 Recipe Box is brought to you by Dean Supply.